DJI Mavic Platinum is the update to the wildly successful DJI Mavic. I purchased my Fly More combo 90 days ago. Let's have a look at what's in the box. The first thing you notice about the drone is the physical size. Toaster, drone, toaster, drone, drone, toaster. It has an exceptionally small footprint that is comparable to a DSLR or portable speaker. The Platinum is the same size as the previous version, with the legs expanding from the body. Beyond the Platinum finish, there are only two updates with this version, the noise and flight time. The Platinum gets an additional 3 minutes flight time per battery, and it's 60% quieter. It has a bunch of features to make it easier to fly and prevent you from losing or crashing it. Takeoff is similar to unlocking an iPad. You just swipe to the right.
The home point has been updated. Please check it on the map.
And unlike cheaper toy-level drones, the Mavic uses GPS to know its position. If you take your hands off the controls, it doesn't drift in the wind or crash to the ground. It just hovers smoothly. When you're learning to fly, there is a beginner mode that limits the distance and height of the drone, as well as the speed that it will move at. This, combined with the autonomous hover, makes it easy to learn how to fly. You don't need any previous drone experience. The Mavic also has front sensors that highlight when you are getting close to an object. The colors change from green to yellow to red as you get closer, and the drone will slow down as you continue to get closer, and an alarm will even sound. The controller uses your smartphone as a display, so you can see what the drone sees. It also displays a series of useful information, such as a map you can use to fly home. The green line shows a direct path back to the takeoff point. The dynamic power bar shows you how much time is left on the battery, and there's a H for when you need to return home. You can also see the strength of the controller and of the satellite connection. At the bottom of the display, the height and distance of the drone relative to the takeoff point is showing. And at the top are the current camera settings. The controller symbol allows you to enter a series of smart modes. I found most of these modes were fairly useless. For example, Tap Fly lets you touch the display to direct the drone without using the controller. The modes that I found genuinely helpful were Active Track, which lets the drone follow an object and perform a perfect cinematic circle around it. Tripod, which is good for taking photos. This drastically reduces the speed of the drone and allows for minor adjustment. Cinematic mode is my default mode. It creates much smoother pictures as you're flying. And sports mode is great for getting around at high speeds. If you want to follow a car or you're battling against strong winds, this mode should have enough power to do the job. In sports mode, the drone can maintain 40 miles per hour. Perhaps the most powerful smart feature is the return to home. If you have lost track of the drone, or you just want to autopilot home, there is a return to home button on the controller. The drone records the point of takeoff. When you press the return to home button, it elevates to a safe altitude, travels directly back to that point, and lowers safely to the ground. By default, if the drone loses connection with the controller, it also returns home. This feature even kicks in if the battery is low. While I love the Mavic, it's not without its weaknesses. DJI releases regular updates for the drone. If you fly only once a month, you'll probably need to update every time you fly. The updates are often more than 100 megabytes and can take over an hour to install. This is a significant barrier to having a quick flight. The camera is the equivalent of a good smartphone camera. It films in 4K, so outside, in good light, the footage looks amazing. But in low light situations, the camera does struggle. The sensors I mentioned before are on the front of the drone, so they're very good at stopping you hitting things as you're going forward. But if you're moving left or right, up, down, backwards, there's no real sensors to stop impact. The camera has the ability to rotate up and down, but not left or right. To shoot left or right, the entire drone needs to rotate, and unless this is done very gently, the smoothness of the footage is destroyed. The worst issue that I continue to encounter is the phone display disconnecting. This is particularly scary if you're flying over a cliff or above the ocean. I've been using the Samsung S7, and it doesn't seem to affect everyone with this phone, but it is a semi-regular problem for me. Normally it will reconnect after 10 seconds or so, but a few times I've just had to use the return to home button and turn the entire drone on and off. Is the Mavic Platinum the right drone for you? Well, it depends what you want. At around 2,000 Australian dollars, it's exceptionally expensive. This is especially true when considering that the DJI Air and Spark offer similar, but not as good performance, for a significantly reduced cost. Outside of the DJI family, there are drones available for well under $500 that are faster and tougher than the Mavic. The Mavic is the right drone for me. The handling is fantastic. The footage looks amazing. I have a range of up to 5 kilometers. It's just a fantastic piece of technology. And I think it's telling that when Will Smith started his YouTube channel, his team bought a DJI Mavic.
It's disgusting.
No, this is the quality of my friendship. That's the quality of my friendship. That's what it is, okay? Now, it's the
If you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up and subscribe below. I'll finish this video with some more footage from the DJI Mavic Platinum. Enjoy.